So this is the first time that I am not allowed to be in the same room with the person that I am reading. Hi, how are you? What is your name?
Brian.
Brian, nice to meet you. I'm Theresa.
Nice to meet you too. My name is Brian. I'm from Holbrook, New York. I'm currently in the Veterans Program in the Yaphank Correctional Facility.
So this session is about your loved ones acknowledging things that are holding you back from healing, for you to embrace life with happiness and joy, and being able to give you that gift of peace. So I just invite you to enjoy these wonderful and beautiful messages from your loved ones.
Yes, ma'am.
So, who's the father figure for you that's on the other side?
My father.
Okay. He tells me things in like one or two words.
That's how he talked.
Okay. And I said to him, you gotta make me feel more. And then he kind of stepped back and then got nervous for whatever reason. Does that make sense to you? What would be his personality?
I had a hard time expressing emotion.
Dad was a quiet dad. He really didn't speak much. I guess that's how his father was. The only thing we really had in common in that he never missed a meet. I wrestled when I was a kid.
Do you move around a lot? You're all over the place.
Yes, ma'am.
And it was from how you were from the time that you were younger, all over the place. Never had that stability. Because your father just said that you've never felt understood. Does that make sense?
Yes, ma'am.
And that all you were doing as a young adult was trying to find yourself, trying to fit in.
Absolutely true what you're saying, ma'am. I come from a broken family.
I didn't live at home. I was a 19-year-old kid running the streets, being like a little punk, I guess you can say. I mean, I had to survive most of my life. You know, my family said, I'm worthless, I'm not this, I'm that, I'm this, I'm that. I mean, you hear that for so many years, you're gonna start to believe it to yourself.
I am also gonna say this, that I don't know what happened and how you ended up here, but your father is showing me something made you turn yourself in.
Yes, ma'am, it's cause I started drinking and drugging, and it was either come here or lose my family.
But your father is saying that that was him. That was his soul that pushed you so you can have the life that you've always dreamed of. And I don't mean to sound corny, but it's a life that you've never thought that you could have. And it's the only way that you could achieve and have that.
Absolutely true.
I do have an open case for a crime, something from 2017. I'm a man, the right thing to do is to turn yourself in, so that's what I did. From Florida, 35-hour bus ride. I mean, it's better for me to walk through the front door by myself than to walk through in handcuffs.
I tasted blood, so that's my symbol for someone that dies tragically, because he restricted my throat area, which is my symbol for that someone either died from something of the throat or couldn't communicate in the end, because they just showed me this accident of this unspeakable tragedy. And they show me the number 3. And I'm gonna share something with you also. When I was on the way here, there was a Rescue 3 fire truck.
That's my dad's company.
Okay. But the crazy thing is that I saw that fire truck on the way over here and something made me look at it.
My father died in the Twin Towers. September 11th, he was a fireman at Rescue 3.
My father died in the World Trade Center. He was a member of Rescue 3, FDNY. He was actually on vacation. He got called in the night before for overtime. I was missing for 11 days. It's not fair. I mean, for years I used to say, you know, my dad died saving 3,000 people, and why couldn't he save me?
Hi. Welcome.
Thank you. I'm Theresa.
And your name?
Deirdre.
Deirdre, it's a pleasure. So today I'm going wedding dress shopping with Vic, but first I'm meeting with a client at my house. This reading is very unique because Maria is actually hearing impaired. So she's here with her interpreter. I've never read someone that is hearing impaired in a private reading. Come on in, we'll get started. My house is still under construction, but that seems to be a running theme with me. I'm always under construction.
I've always believed in mediums. So I'm looking forward to getting information from my loved ones, and really, I have no idea what's going to show up.
So I tend to talk very fast. So if I do talk fast, just don't be afraid to tell me to slow down.
Perfect.
Not going to interrupt anything. So I'm still going to give a little speech on how I read and communicate with the spirits, because I believe mediums are different. I want spirit to acknowledge things that have happened since they've died, feelings and emotions that you haven't shared with anyone else here in the physical world. It validates that your loved one's soul is with you at that exact moment. So, there is a mother energy that steps forward. Is your mom departed?
Yes.
So know that your mom is stepping forward.
Wow.
Dimes. Do you find dimes in odd places?
Yes. Yes. My mom said if it was two with heads up, that meant good luck. That was unbelievable. When she mentioned, do you sometimes find dimes? I was like, yes, I do. I always find them. How could she possibly know that?
There is something about... Oh, are you going on a vacation or a trip?
Yes.
And how do you connect with a tree? She had me write, tree, bench, garden.
So my sister's house, that's my sister's house.
Because she showed me you going there. So are you visiting her or you're going to...
Yes, yes.
Perfect. So know that her soul is with you when you are doing that.
Aw. I was so happy to hear my mom. She was always making sure that the children were okay. Her children were the most precious things in the world. She raised us alone. You know, I felt safe with her. But when she passed away, nothing was the same.
Your mom made me feel like, growing up, she could not sign to you.
Oh, my God.
But how do I say this? I feel like your mom's always pushing you to do things. That's how she was, right? Like, you're not different than anybody else. You can do all that.
Yes, absolutely.
So it's a way of her still encouraging you, don't hold back.
My mom had such a strong personality, and she would try her best to communicate with me. I would use lip reading, but she couldn't sign. And as I grew up, I learned speech and practiced that more, and she encouraged me to speak more. She would always cheer me up and inspire me, and I really appreciated that.
Your mom talks about a prayer that you say.
All the time, every day.
And she made me feel like it was a prayer that you always had, that she always said with you.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So no thanking you for your prayers. And she says, tell my sweet Maria, it's never goodbye.
I love you, Mom. My mom had heart surgery in 2003. We didn't expect her to die, and she actually just died in her sleep after the surgery. And all of a sudden, she was gone.